Alors, because we want to study in a rational and efficient manner, we saw sucky and now we will go for sucke. D'accord? So let's have a look at this sentence. What I love. What I love. How could you translate what I love? Using, obviously, because this is the idea of the lesson, ce que. It's not the lesson, the exercise. Ce que. Go for it. Alors voilà, pas de problème, so everything seems to be extremely good. So, ce que, as we started to put, so I don't know, Maurice Johnson, sorry, Maurice, we're just using French or English here, so I am sorry, I will have to click on you, I guess. Don't take it bad, but that's it. Merci, Maurice. Look, in that case, we will go for ce que, and then after that, we still need to put, we agree, the subject, je, d'accord? So whether you want to go for aimer, I mean, I've been putting aimer, you could go for adorer if you want, no problem, no problem. So, but then remember, ce que, then you squeeze your subject, je, apostrophe in both cases, and after that your verb. Ce que j'aime, ce que j'adore. Très bien, look at the next one, 1 second, because apparently the machine doesn't want to change the page. What I admire. So what I admire, how could you say that in French? Allez-y. Alors, Kirill is asking a big question. What's the difference between qui and que? Well, in that case, this is what we call pronom relatif. I would definitely invite you to have a look at the video that I've been making, but if you look at it so far, ce qui, it's to replace the subject. So it means that basically you have ce qui, and then you have, after that, the verb. You don't have a subject because ce qui is the subject. Ce qui est beau, as we had. Ce qui is the subject, est is the verb. In that situation, ce que will replace what we call this grammatical object. So, ce que, and look, in that situation, ce que j'admire, as you can see, we need to have the subject. Je is the subject. What I admire. I admire, sujet, verb, and after that, que, ce que, will be for the object. So in that situation, it will be ce que j'admire. Remember, admirer, regular verb from the first group, extremely simple to conjugate, so in that case, it should be with the e in the end. Ensuite, alors, attendez. So, what you do is what you need to translate. Yossi is asking what the difference between adorer and admirer. Adorer, it's to adore. It's to love a lot. And then admirer, it's to admire. So, it's slightly different. I don't know if in your language you've got the differences between the two. But in fact, for at least in French and I guess in English, it's slightly different. Let's agree, if we don't go too far, you see, let's say that adorer, the first concept of adorer, but it's been changing a lot, but it was something that was related to religion. Adorer un dieu. Admirer, you can admire a person. But now it's not as clear as it used to be a long, long time ago. So in that situation, ce que tu fais. Alors, Samantha Alonso is asking ce que and not ce qui. I just explained that 1 minute ago. So you need to go back. So in that situation, ce que, and then we will put the subject, tu, we agree, fait. If you want to go like Lisbeth for the vous form, totally possible, no problem. Ce que vous faites, hein? It is really good. So ce que tu fais, ce que vous faites. So what we want, what we want, how could you translate that with this ce que structure? Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at your things. So, of course, I would accept two things. The first one would be the classic translation of we want, and it would be nous voulons. Ce que nous voulons. Be careful, because I can see that I think it was Ashley or somebody else has been using this on. I would accept it. Remember that on. In that situation, you conjugate the verb in the third person, so it would be on veut, V-E-U-T, ce qu'on veut. In some cases, we don't really use that because obviously this sound can be a bit rude and it's not really nice, but it's up to you after that. Ce que nous voulons, or then ce qu'on veut. Voilà, regardez le prochain. Let's have a look at the next one. So now it's getting a bit bigger. What you say interests me. What you say interests me. How would you structure that with this ce que structure that we have? Alors Ashley saying personne ne dit nous. Well, it depends where you are. It depends. Alors let's have a look at the translation of this sentence. Ce que tu dis, so we agree that in that case the verb dire should be conjugated in the second form. So it's tu dis, D-I-S. And then the verb is intéressé, d'accord? And of course you will put the pronoun before me. You drop the, you put the apostrophe. Ce que tu dis m'intéresse. Ce que tu dis m'intéresse would be the proper translation for that. And it seems that everything is okay for you. Remember, if you go for ce que vous, in that situation, it should be dites, hein, D-I-T-E-S. It's a tricky, tricky verb. Hein. Je dis, I-S, tu dis, I-S, il dit, I-T, nous disons, vous dites, D-I-T-E-S, ils, elles disent. Très bien. Valéa Torres, I'm sorry, but we only speak French or English here. Merci beaucoup, Valé. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you say makes me sad. What you say makes me sad. Allez-y. Alors, Ashley, si j'avais un entretien sur place, je vais dire tout. No, but it depends, Ashley. You know, keep in mind that if it's extremely formal, and really, it's an advice, huh? If it's extremely formal and you are interacting with person of what we could call a certain age, I would advise you to go for nous first, and then listen to the way people will use. It's really according to the places where you go and the persons that you are interacting with. So go for nous first instead of going for on, because trust me, there is a generation that considers that on was not proper at all, and well, at different type of levels. And I mean, you get my point. Ce que tu dis me rend triste. So in that situation, well, we could go for attristé. Yeah, I can see that MJ is going for attristé. So I wanted to quiz you and to see you if you wanted to reuse attristé that we saw, or then if you want to use rendre triste, which is the other option. Remember, attristé, as MJ has been writing that, and it's really, really good. Merci beaucoup, MJ. So, ce que tu dis me rend triste, ce que tu dis m'attriste, hein, the verb that we saw a few minutes ago. Allez, on continue. What you say makes me laugh. What you say makes me laugh. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look, and it seems that everything is okay because basically we reuse the same structure that we've been using several times already. Ce que tu dis, d'accord, me fait rire. Alors, if you want to go for amuser, well, I could because Kirill wanted to use amuser. Remember, it should be m'amuse, hein, in that case, M apostrophe and then amuse. Hein. Ce que tu dis m'amuse could be an option, but amuser, it's not really it's not really to laugh. In that case, it's really the ha ha ha, me fait rire. Ce que tu dis me fait rire. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you say worries me. What you say worries me, same structure with the ce que, and make the sentence. Allez-y. Yeah, Ashley, and this is always my advice to people. It's better to look too polite than the opposite, because you can always go back from the too polite to something that is less polite. When you start, you see my point. It's difficult to change the image that people will have of you. Alors, so far so good, félicitations, it's exactly the same structure that we've been having since the beginning, ce que tu dis, hein? Ce que tu dis, same thing here, D-D-I-S, in that situation we'll use this verb inquiéter, inquiéter, so after that before that, sorry, you put the pronoun, hein? So it's pronom complément d'objet direct, apostrophe, of course, because your verb is starting with the vowel or sound of a vowel. Ce que tu dis m'inquiète. Lanora wanted to go for préoccupé. It could be a good option too. Ouais. Ce que tu dis me préoccupe. Hein. It would be totally correct, Lanora. Merci beaucoup en tout cas. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you do is your business. What you do is your business. Allez, same thing, ce que, and then you structure your sentence. Merci. Alors, je regarde vos petites choses. Regardez. Personally, I would go for this structure. Ce que tu fais te regarde. Remember that regarder can be used like that. Ça me regarde, it's my business. Ça te regarde, it's your business. So remember that the verb regarder can be definitely used in this situation. So, ce que tu fais te regarde. Ce qu'il fait le regarde. Ce qu'elle fait la regarde. Try to play with this structure because this is really the structure that we would use in most of the cases to express this this concept. After that, you went for ce que tu fais, c'est tes affaires. Yeah, but it's not really, it's spoken, it could be extremely informal. I was offering you the proper way to make it short and to make it quite clear, and especially to introduce this, probably for you, maybe, a new way to conceive the meaning of regarder, d'accord? So regarder, it's not only to watch, but it's also like this concept of it concerns you. It's your business, it's my business, c'est, ça me regarde, ça te regarde. Qu'est-ce qu'elle dit, Victoria Jacques? This is my brain on French aujourd'hui. It's bubbling everywhere.